This episode of On Further Reflection contains coarse language and reference of drug use. Viewer discretion is advised.
So, what exactly was this place used for?
It was some old hydroelectric dam. Used to power old Portheim before most of the population moved further inland.
And it's abandoned?
Don't worry, Astrid. It's completely safe. A lot of people have gone down there.
I'm not worried. I just don't really see the interest in going.
It's history, sis!
And?
Listen, you'll understand when you see it. Just the way nature completely overtakes the buildings. It's beautiful.
Sure. You know what else is beautiful? The new Lucenus game that I could be playing right now.
You can play your game when we get home. In the meantime, we are going to enjoy a little bit of nature.
You sound like Mom.
Good. Mom is an intelligent woman, so I consider that a compliment.
How far are you in Lucenus?
Oh, I beat the second trial.
Hey, nice! I just finished the fourth one myself.
No way! How did you reach the treasure chest that's up on the ledge in the fire trial?
Oh, that was really easy. Yeah, okay, so you see, you have to get the lava to flow over to the...
Sorry to interrupt, gamers, but we're almost there.
Really? How? There's nothing but trees around here.
Did you think there would just be a driveway all the way to the powerhouse?
Well, people did work there, right? How'd they get there?
I guess maybe there used to be a road.
According to the Urbex website I found this place on, there is still a road. In fact, a lot of the hike will be on pavement. We just need to get over the ridge first.
So much for enjoying nature.
Hey, if the hike is anything like the photos I saw, it will be great. Trust me.
I guess. Oh, I love this song. Turn it up.
Oh, this is that Ben guy, right?
He's a Portheim local, you know.
Really? Do you think I can meet him while we're here?
Why? You got a crush on him?
What? No. Definitely not. I just like his music.
Sure.
It's true. He's got a really nice voice.
I doubt he'd appreciate random strangers showing up at his house. But we can always see if he's playing locally.
Please, can we? Oh, meeting Ben Rogerson would make this whole stupid trip worth it.
Oh, come on now. Surely spending quality time with your sister and I is worth something.
You tell me how to get that treasure chest, and maybe I won't consider this a complete waste of time.
Okay, this is as far as we can go by car. We'll be going on foot the rest of the way there.
Okay. Everyone got their sunscreen on?
Yep.
Astrid?
I don't need it.
Astrid, put on your sunscreen. We aren't getting out of this car until you do.
You promise?
Put it on, sis.
Fine. Happy?
Yep. Let's see. Water? Mm-hmm. Snacks? Air mace, emergency blankets, knife, flaring lighter. Okay, I think we're good to go.
I've got the TP, sanitizer, and rechargeable batteries for our phones.
Right, perfect. Let's get on with it.
Yay! Can't wait.
A shadow
like sun.
The start of the trail should be just past this bridge.
Are you kidding me? This bridge. It looks like it would break if a leaf falls on it. There's absolutely no way it will support our weight.
It's fine. Just avoid the holes.
I'll go first, and you can follow behind me.
Kristie, maybe I should go first.
It's fine, Jackson. I'll be careful.
Okay.
You cannot be serious. Is this what you two do?
What do you mean?
This is dangerous, Kristie. I would have been safer staying at home alone all weekend.
You heard what Mom said. No way I was going to leave you alone so you could throw a party.
I wasn't going to.
You're a 17-year-old. Of course you were going to have a party.
Maybe you would have. But I honestly would have just stayed home alone and played Lucernus.
I actually believe that.
Jackson.
What? It's a good game. Especially if she's in the fire trial.
I don't want to hear another word about this Lucernus game, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Because you hate everything I like.
Oh, you know that's not it, sis. I just... We really haven't seen each other all year, and I want to spend time catching up with you.
You're the one who ditched me and Mom.
Going to university isn't ditching you and Mom.
Yeah. Well, while you went off to university, I basically just went to school and played video games. There. You're all caught up.
Okay, but why don't we talk about all this after we cross this bridge, eh?
Right. Astrid, make sure you copy my steps exactly, okay?
Yeah.
Okay, this path is safe.
I could see more of the river than I can the bridge.
You just watched me walk over here. It's fine.
Want me to hold your hand?
Huh?
Or a piggyback?
I can do it!
Okay. When you put your foot down, just test the wood before shifting your weight. If it feels like the wood might break, then try a different spot.
Right.
See? You made it!
That wasn't so bad.
I'll make an urban explorer out of you yet!
Don't get ahead of yourself.
Jackson, what do you think you're doing?
Well, I can make it.
Oh, don't you dare even think about jumping over the bridge!
I've jumped further.
Yeah, but that wasn't over a raging river! Not to mention we are hours away from the nearest hospital! If you get hurt...
Fine.
I think you could have done it.
Oh, I know I could have. But thanks for believing in me, Astrid.
You two are going to be the death of me.
Says the woman who made me climb a mountain to see an old decommissioned lighthouse.
Come on, let's keep moving. We've got a lot of ground to cover, and we're already behind schedule because someone had to do their hair and makeup this morning.
What if we aren't the only people dumb enough to be doing this trail? This could be the day I meet my soulmate, and I refuse to look like I just rolled out of bed. You know, like how you look right now, sis.
You really think your soulmate would be a hiker? You're more likely to meet your future partner at the gaming expo next month.
Yeah, well, maybe they also have an older sibling who drags them into the middle of nowhere because no one trusts them too.
It's not like we don't have a reason to be nervous leaving you home alone.
I told you, I only invited a couple of friends over. I had no idea they were going to bring the rest of the class.
Hey, people make mistakes. It's how we learn. Right, Kristie?
I suppose so.
So let's just put all that behind us and enjoy this hike, yeah?
Yeah. Okay.
I guess I can try to have that.
Great. So, according to the instructions online, we go around that bend and there will be a railroad track. We follow that for about a mile, then there should be a path through the trees that will lead us to the road.
A mile? How long is that?
Should be about a 20 or 30 minute walk at most. Depends on how quickly you can move in those little sneakers of yours.
What's wrong with my shoes?
For starters, no ankle support.
She told me she had hiking shoes, so I assumed she meant boots. Otherwise, I would have taken her out to get proper shoes.
These are what I wear when I'm walking places.
Hiking is very different from walking.
How was I supposed to know? I don't hike.
If your feet start to hurt, let me know, okay?
I will. You know, when you said railroad tracks, I was thinking they'd also be abandoned, but these look like they're still being used.
Oh, they are. But there shouldn't be any trains on the weekend.
Are we allowed to be here?
Technically, no. But like Jackson said, nothing runs along here today, so it's fine.
Is it? Are you making me commit a crime right now, sis?
Of course not.
It's sort of a gray area.
I'm telling Mom you turned me into a criminal.
You do, and I'll tell Mom about the stash of edibles under your bed.
You wouldn't dare!
Try me.
How do you even know about that anyways? You going through my stuff?
Oh, chill. I saw you putting them away last night. If you don't want people to see, you should close your door.
It's for headaches, okay?
Hey, you don't have to explain anything to me. It's not like I didn't have my own stash when I was your age.
You did? You told me you've never tried it.
Oh, I've never tried smoking it. Oh, come on, don't look at me like that.
Like what?
Like you've just heard the worst news in your life.
You know my feelings on that matter.
I know, Jackson, and that's why I don't do it anymore.
Am I missing something?
Nah, it's nothing important. Hey, want to race to the end of the railroad tracks?
What? You want me to sprint a mile?
Don't you think you can do it?
I know I can't.
Come on. You can think of it as Lucianus training. Learn how to be a real life hero.
Yeah, no thanks. I would rather just play a hero.
All right. Have it your way. Kristie, what about you?
Absolutely not. But knock yourself out.
Okay, walking it is.
This is the worst.
The offer for a piggyback still stands.
I'm not 4 years old.
I know, but we've still got a long way to go.
Why don't we take a break? Get out of the sun for a bit.
Yeah, good idea. The lake is right beyond those trees. We can go down there and cool off for a bit.
There's a lake?
You didn't notice?
No. I was too busy looking at the tracks to make sure I didn't trip.
You're missing all the best stuff keeping your head down like that.
Come on, let's go check out the lake.
Okay. Glorious shade.
See, aren't you glad you put on sunscreen? You'd be a tomato right now if you hadn't.
Yeah, leave me alone.
Want some water?
Thanks. That hits the spot.
God, I love doing this with you. No, I'm serious. There is no one I would rather see the world with than you.
I know how you feel.
We've seen some pretty cool places together.
Mm-hmm. And we are going to see tons more places in the future. Ha ha.
Sorry. You two were just being so nauseating.
Why don't you dunk your head in the lake? Might make you feel better.
I wouldn't do that if I were you.
Why not?
Rain-eating parasites.
What?
Jackson!
What? It's true. Some lakes aren't safe to swim in, and I didn't look into whether this one was parasite-free or not.
I'm never going swimming again.
It's fine. The water looks clear. Besides, you'd think there would be signs up to stop people from going in if it wasn't safe.
Except we technically aren't supposed to be here.
Fair point. This lake just got a little less romantic.
How did you two end up doing this whole urban exploration thing anyways?
It was our first year of university.
Halloween, to be exact.
Right, Halloween. A bunch of people were throwing a party at an abandoned amusement park, and the two of us ended up going.
But not together.
No, we actually didn't know each other yet.
We met at the party. I didn't really know anyone, just the one friend I went with. And parties? Well, they aren't really my scene. So I ended up taking photos of the amusement park instead.
I saw him taking photos and was curious, so I asked what he was doing. We ended up exploring the amusement park all night.
Like watching the sunrise and everything?
We might have climbed the Ferris wheel to watch the sunrise.
Oh, really? I don't think Mom would be too happy to hear about that.
And she won't hear about it, right?
We'll see. So, you two lovebirds ended up watching the sunrise and decided that urban exploration was just your thing.
Not quite. We actually didn't exchange numbers or anything. We realized how late it was and parted ways.
How'd you two end up together then?
The following Halloween, we both ended up on the same ghost tour.
Ghost tour?
It was this silly tour through the old sewer tunnels. The city was built on top of what essentially was another city. No ghost, though.
Obviously.
What do you mean, obviously?
Obviously because ghosts aren't real.
You don't believe in ghosts?
Do you?
Of course. There's been too many sightings and videos of unexplainable occurrences.
Everything is explainable, Jackson. Not to mention, it's super easy to fake things nowadays.
You know, that's fair. But, I don't know. I think it's possible that there are spirits all around us.
I never realized you were so superstitious.
And I never knew you were so skeptical.
All right. My feet have stopped throbbing. Let's get moving. The quicker we get to this power station, the quicker we can head home.
Astrid has a point. We're burning daylight.
Yeah. I'd rather not spend the night out here.
Why?
Because of the grizzly bears, kid.
Grizzlies!
Stop scaring her, Jackson.
What? She asked me a question.
I'd rather see a ghost than a grizzly. Are we lost?
Nope. I know exactly where we are.
Then how much longer is this road? It feels like we've been walking forever.
We should be reaching the main entrance soon.
Oh, I think I see it.
Really?
Yeah, look. There's a gate.
Why is it closed? And why are there a bunch of no trespassing signs all over it?
They are meant for cars. Lots of people do this hike.
Kristie.
Don't worry. The old signs. It's perfectly legal.
Why do I not believe you?
Honest. There's been tons of people up here recently, and no one's gotten into any sort of trouble.
Well, you can always stay here, Astrid. Keep an eye out for bears.
I'm coming.
So,
what?
Are you having fun yet?
I don't know if I'd use the word fun.
I saw that smile you had on your face.
I was just... Okay, fine. I'll admit that it's sort of cool here. It's so quiet. Kind of feels like we are the only ones left in the whole world.
Now you're starting to get it! And when you see the abandoned building, oh, it is just so surreal!
Are there other places around here like this?
Not many, no. There's a few places closer to home, though, if you're interested in doing some more exploring.
Maybe. Let's see how I feel once we get to this power station.
We must be getting close.
Yeah, we just gotta go down this hill, then a little bit west. We should reach the cliffside after that.
Cliffside?
Yeah, power station's built on the cliff over the lake. It's a hydro station, remember? They needed access to water.
Oh, that makes sense. I just realized we are going to have to climb back up this hill.
Don't worry, we'll rest up at the powerhouse, regain our energy.
Have a snack? I'm so hungry.
Yes, we can have some snacks.
Ah! Look at that!
Is that a car?
Well, shit. It is. Looks like an old pickup. Nice find, Astrid. It's so covered by the ferns that I probably wouldn't have noticed it.
Can I get a pic?
For sure. Go ahead.
This is pretty cool. How long do you think this thing has been here?
What do you think, Jackson? 15? 20 years?
I don't know how long it's been abandoned, but judging from the design, I'd say this truck is from the 70s, maybe the 80s.
Really? That old?
Well, I mean, the powerhouse was closed down in the late 60s, so it sort of makes sense.
Think it was an employee's car?
Maybe.
But why would they just leave it here?
Ooh, maybe a bear got them.
Jackson, not funny.
Sorry about that.
Well, let's keep moving. If we want to rest and explore the powerhouse, we need to get going.
One more pick.
Quickly.
Sis, Jackson, get in here.
Hmm?
I want a photo of the three of us together.
For sure. Let me take the photo. I've got longer arms.
Here, take it on my phone.
Sure. All right. That turn out okay?
Yeah, it's perfect.
We finally made it.
Hey, this is pretty damn nice.
Nice? It's creepy.
You know, that's part of the appeal.
The windows are all boarded up.
You're right.
What does that mean?
Well, normally there's a way to get inside. The website did say we could enter the building, right?
Yeah, there was definitely at least one person that posted about being able to go inside.
Let's take a look around. Maybe there's a window on the other side of the building.
Yeah, maybe.
Hey, sis, check out this board!
What's up?
Looks like someone wrote a message.
Nightmare inside?
What do you think that means?
I'm not sure. Maybe it's unsafe inside? The floorboards may have rotted.
Why wouldn't they just write not safe?
It's probably people just trying to scare others away. Bet they throw a lot of parties here.
You think that's all it is?
Definitely. Hey, why don't you two go sit down and have some of those snacks? I'll try and find a way in and then join you.
Ooh, sure. Sounds like a good idea. We can go sit on that little rock ledge over there.
Yeah, okay.
Protein bar?
Thanks. Ugh, this is disgusting.
Too cardboardy for you?
Tastes like those really gross cheap chocolates Grandma used to buy us, only much, much, much staler.
Yeah, that's about right.
Didn't you bring anything better?
I have some crackers and dried fruit, but I was saving those for the car ride back.
Nuh-uh. We are stopping at a drive-thru on the way home. Hand me the good stuff.
Finish the power bar first. No sense in wasting it.
You can have it.
After you've taken a bite out of it, no way.
Okay, fine. Then at least hand me some water.
Sure.
So, what if I have to go to the bathroom?
There's some bushes over there.
You're kidding.
Or you can wait and see if there's some place to go in the powerhouse, but the woods will probably be cleaner.
Blech. Gross.
Bathroom aside, what do you think? Neat. Huh?
Yeah, it's cool.
But...
I don't know. Doesn't it kind of feel... evil?
Evil? It's just an abandoned building, Astrid. Yeah, it looks a little creepy since it's boarded up and the grime is a little off-putting, but it's just a building.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Hey, I found a way in!
Hello? Is someone there?
Huh?
What the...
Who was that?
Hello?
Help! Please! Help me! I fell!
Oh, shit. Astrid, stay here.
No way.
Okay, but just stay behind me.
Are you okay down there?
My leg! It's tangled in the vines! I can't get up!
Hey, hang on. We'll get you out of there.
Jackson, wait. How are we supposed to get down there? It's at least a 20-foot drop.
The cliff doesn't look too steep, and there's lots of rocks. I can climb down.
What? Absolutely not!
We can't just leave him there. You have some rope, right?
Yeah, but I don't think it's long enough.
It can probably get me at least halfway down.
But...
Come on, Chris. Who knows how badly he's hurt?
Just don't get yourself hurt, okay?
Hey, we've climbed worse.
True.
I've got this. Rope?
Here.
Thanks. Okay. That should hold. But Astrid, I need you to keep an eye on the knot. Make sure it stays secured around the gate.
You got it.
Hey, buddy. I'm coming down.
Wait. Love you.
Love you too.
Be careful.
Okay. Slow.
Thank you! Thank you for helping!
Yeah, no problem.
Jackson!
I'm okay. Okay, I'm untying the rope.
Be careful!
Thank God! I thought I was going to die out here.
How long have you been down here?
A couple of days.
Shit. Okay, I'll get you out of there. Just hold on.
There's too many vines. I couldn't untangle myself.
Good thing I have a knife. What happened anyway?
I was with my friends. They went inside that building. But I didn't want to. I was waiting outside. Then I heard a noise. I tried looking inside and something charged at me. It startled me and I fell.
And your friends?
I don't know. I haven't seen or heard anyone until you and your group arrived.
That's odd.
Did you see any signs of them?
Not yet, but we did just arrive.
Everything okay down there?
Yeah, all good.
Thank you.
Think you can stand?
Maybe.
Whoa, easy there.
My leg. Shit, it hurts.
We have food and water you can have. But we need to figure out how to get you back up to the top of the cliff. You think you can climb?
I don't know. Maybe once I stretch out my leg muscles a little more.
We could try to go through the powerhouse. If we hop over to that rock...
No! No, please. Let me rest a moment.
Yeah, sure.
Do you need me to come down there?
No, it's okay. Just need a moment. Can you toss down a water and protein bar?
Yeah, one sec.
Thank you. Here, some water.
Thank you.
I'm Jackson, by the way.
Damian.
That's Kristie up there and Astrid's behind her.
So, you came to explore the power station too?
Yeah. Kristie and I love hiking to places like this.
Well, I'm glad you came. I'd probably be dead without you coming here, so...
You didn't bring a phone?
I had one, but it was in my pocket when I fell, and when I came to, it was gone. It's probably at the bottom of the lake.
Here, some food.
Thanks, again.
Jackson?
Kristie?
You coming back up?
Soon! How are you feeling, bud? Think you can try climbing now?
I can try.
Shit! Okay, let's hit you down. Easy. Easy.
I'm sorry.
Hey, no. Nothing to be sorry about, man.
What do we do now? I don't think I can walk.
Yeah. Hey! Kristie, Astrid, I'm gonna need you both to come down here.
What? Why?
We're going to have to drag Damian up through the powerhouse. There should be stairs to the upper level.
Can we even get into the station from down there?
Yeah, there's a window we can climb through.
Okay, we're coming down.
There must be another way.
Unless your leg heals itself, we don't have another choice.
But you didn't hear what I heard.
What did you hear?
Something evil. The noise was like nothing I'd ever heard before. It was like something out of my darkest nightmare.
This episode of On Further Reflection was written by Jenna Oliver, starring the voice talents of
Lauren Kong as Astrid Pearce,
Jenna Rose as Kristie Pearce.
Maxadrian Burton as Jackson Briggs.
I'll be Kumar as Damian Brody.
Wayward Dreamers was written, composed, and performed by Key Garland. Key art by Arthur Ikuta. Logos by blinddeafghost. Hello, this is Jenna of Wolf Magpie Media. Thank you so much for listening to episode 1 of On Further Reflection. Episode 2 will be released on Monday, July 17th. Episode 3 will be released on Monday, July 24th. And on July 31st, we will be releasing our full feature version of On Further Reflection, which contains all 3 episodes in one, completely uninterrupted for your binging pleasure. If you'd like to learn more about Wolf and Magpie Media and the stories we tell, be sure to check out our Linktree, linktr.ee/wolfmagpiemedia. Thanks again, and we'll see you next week.